Welcome guys, today we're gonna play Ostwif again. This will be episode 2 of our Ostwif series. In the last episode you have seen that we built the 9 houses for our families. We built the forestry, the carpentry, the smithy and the thatchery. And we start working on our farm. We have added 2 fields. The first year will be wheat, then potato, and then a fallow. A fallow will be for our livestock. That will be working on in this episode. We also placed the windmill, so that for the wheat they can make flour and they can sell it to our families. So let's get straight into it. Oh yeah guys, I adjust the audio so the sound of the game is a little bit lower, and I got a new mic, so I think in this episode you will be can hear me loud and clear. Thank you guys for watching. If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thanks. We hit the play button. We have here 3 workers. I placed the worker in the windmill. The second field is this one. We first will start with potatoes and then a fallow field and then wheat again. We were gonna make another field so that we have 3 so they can rotate. So every year there will be a fallow field, a wheat field, and a potato field. So we're gonna place another field. I think we'll be just do it here. This field we will start with the fallow, then wheat, and then the potato. We're gonna activate it. And I think on this side of the map we will make a fishing dock and a ship making dock. I'm not sure, the boat yard, this one. I'm gonna place them here. Also in this episode we will make the marketplace so that we can sell and buy goods from other cities. I think we just place it here. A little bit warm for our road, for the farm workers. And also with the marketplace you can buy livestock, chickens, cows, sheep. And horses, yeah, and pigs also. This one. There's no wheat, so he has nothing to do. So then he can go work on building. We'll speed up a little bit. When we get it the trading post, we can go to this city, Mereva, Ambalaklia, and the Derkatsi. Just wait for this one to build. We first gonna start with a sheep farm. And I think we're just gonna place it right here. Yeah. We left some room on this side. And that is for the hay. We also gonna need that. We We're just gonna play some hate wires. Gonna remove this one. Then first gonna place two of these. And then we will place the big hay barrack. Right here. This one can store up to 7,000 hay. And you've got also a smaller one, yes. 10,000 of 1,000 hay that you can have. Here when they are building a building, you can see the parts that they are doing. You can see the wood, some parts, the nail, and work in clay. So you can see a little bit on how far they are with the building. The architecture in this game, how they make it when they are building, is just amazing. Here we see an icon pops up. It says not enough food variety. So that means that I think it was three kind of food types and then they are fine. But yeah, when the wheat is ready and the potatoes, they have enough other food supply. So then the buttons will be gone. As long as they not cry for food, then everything is fine. The town hall, that's the main building of your city. I think we're just gonna place it here next to the farm, as close as possible. This one we just first put on a hold. It's not, yeah, it is an important building because of the you can change the taxes and yeah, change how much a worker gets paid. So yeah, that's important for when you're running out of money. But that's not our biggest concern at this moment. They have built a quarter of the trading post. So we just have to wait a little bit longer. No. Now this one is enough for one worker. Because we don't need it now that much. This game is really for anyone just have a calm play. It's just making a city and keep that happy and alive. There's no war involved with other games. So yeah, it's just calm and relaxing. It looks a bit like Banished, but I think this one's a little bit better than that one. But also Banished I like to play, so. Yeah, it is also a game that's not hurried. Don't have a worker there. I think we need it. Ok, because of the cards need a repair. Yeah, we are basically the mayor of this city, so we have to control everything. They are asking for nails. Yeah. He has metal parts to zero, so they only can focus on the nails. I see they need some more charcoal, so I will make another one. Right around the corner. I'm gonna pause the video for a short while, and we're gonna wait until the trading post and the sheep farm and everything is built. So when that is done, I will get back to you. Unfortunately, on this part of the video, the mic wasn't working anymore. This part I was checking the trading dock and the sheep farm, and we added a worker to the windmill so that they can produce flour, and the flour will be sold at the market stall. You can see that every house has more than 3 or 4 different kind of foods, so that the icon is not showing that they have not enough variety of food sources. We are now gonna build some more houses to increase the popularity, because we need some more workers. Here we try to get a worker and a manager to the trading post. We added some workers to the sheep farm, only women. We had nothing to sell at this point, so we wait for the house to getting built, and then we will make the town hall, so that we can change the tax for the people in our city. Here we have another messenger from a town, but we have nothing to offer or to buy from them. So you can see the different things that you can buy and sell. Now you can see how winter is ending. You see the snow is melting. Just the small details in this game that make it a lot more interesting to watch and to play. Now you know spring is coming. If you want to have a messenger straight away, you have to pay some money for it. But I think it's more effective to wait till they come and not to pay for it. So we place another well because the citizens are complaining about that they not have enough water. They also play a small dock where the citizens can also get some water for production of livestock. The platform that you place in the water you can't use for the citizens, so you need a well for the people only. And now the houses are built, we are gonna start building the town hall. So when that one is done, we can change the economy and earn some more from taxes. So a message from Alaclia that they sent a messenger so we can buy our sheep. I will buy 4 sheep and 1 ram so that we can breed also. And I will buy some iron because iron is the only part that we can't mine in this game, not yet. Maybe later on it will be available, but we can place a smeltery, that's this one, that can change the iron ore into iron, but we can't mine, so we also can buy iron ore from, I thought, this city. The sheep are arriving. There they come. Fast runners. They go to this fallow field. I'm not sure if it's true, but I think when you have fallow fields and you use them for your sheep or other livestock, that the nutrition will be going up. But maybe if you only have a fallow field it's also the same, but I'm not sure. Now we have sheep here, we can see hay reserves are 5 months, so we can last the winter. The winter is 3 to 4 months, from end of November till end of February. So you don't have to worry about that. The town hall is built, so now we can check our economy. The finished house rent at this point is 30, but we will raise it to 75. land tax a little bit more, 50. Wheel taxes, every family that has over 100, we will tax an extra 1. So we get a lot more back from our families that are rich. We can check if someone, no, only 90, 109, so that one. Those also, this one, and here, here. They don't need that money as much as the lower wheeled families are, so we could take it from them. I think we will gonna build a cow shed. And then a big hay bullock also here. And if it's, oh, not that one, this one. Maybe here. For the cow shed we need also to make a ploeg. We need 2 oxes for them, so that's a bull. If you have any questions so far, please leave a comment below. I will try to answer it, and if I'm not sure about it, I will look it up for you and see you there. If you think I'm doing something wrong, please let me know, and I will change it in the next video. If you place Austria for yourself, let me know how much population you have reached the maximum. I've seen cities of 1700 population. So if you have a big city, let me know, and also if it works like with the food supply and things like that. I would love to read that. This is the normal speed. Looks amazing. If you imagine that this game is built by just one developer and it took him some years, that I know, but the details are amazing. Just everything, how it is placed and make, and how they built a house or anything. It looks amazing. When the sheep are breeding, they get one newborn sheep or lamb in a year, and I'm not sure if that's because you have only one ram or anything else, but I always have my play time on the game speed on the tree, so the X12, otherwise it will take a long time. hit this one the wrong way. It was only for production, that's what it says, but this for citizens, of course. We got the next messenger. And as you can see here, we have the iron ore that we can change into iron. They have pigs, cows and horses, so I will check if our cow shed, yes, it's done. So we put two workers in there, and I hope they're gonna work here. Getting one away from there. Yeah. Also, only a woman can work here. Yeah, we have a 1 mil here, but yeah, let them take some hay and water. So that we have something for when the cows are arriving. To 3 cows. Let's see how much is an ox compared to a bull. Ox is 40 and the bull is also 40. Then I do it like this. 3 cows, 1 bull and 2 oxen. And then we have a deal. The next thing also is making some more houses. So that we can expand our city. Let's see if we can fit them in here. This will work. Then the next one right next to it. So, 2 more houses. Our income is not so high. Salary is a lot of money. I think the village house rent we can go up to 1, the land tax 75. And if you hit the house, you can also see it. This the monthly income is 5, land tax 150. So with the high rent, they pay 250 a month, and then for 250 they can buy food and things like that. So I think that will be fine. I think we can put 1,000 potato in here to sell, so we can get some money from the production chain also. Yeah, this will be wheat. This fall over now, potato. I think we will start with making a boatyard and a fishing dock. Boatyard we will make here, and the fishing dock right on the other side. Oh, uneven terrain, too bad. Then we also placed on this side, if that's possible, yeah. First we'll finish the houses. The big hay barrack is filling up, so that's a good thing. When it's winter and they're running out, you can run to this side to get some more for the cows also. And we got the cows here, so I will make a ploeg for this farm. And yeah, I know there's no carpenter, but it will be soon. And there he is. So the house complete. Here you see what they are needed. There's 2 animals, 2000 wood and 20 metal parts. So we're also gonna up this one to 20. Got nails enough for this period. So we have to not forget that we hit the supply for oxen, because otherwise they will die. Then you have did it all for nothing. Hay and water, nice. And a new messenger for Mareva is this city. We don't have anything to buy from them. And nothing to sell. The potatoes are also in here. I see we got 2 newborns. One is 2 months old and the other is just born. 2 males, so here we have a new family. The woman is working at the sheep farm and the other is a builder. And they have a 2-year-old son. And you can see here they pay a little bit more land tax than this city of a house. That's just because of that they have more land than the other one. So it's just like in real life when you have to pay for your crown that you buy or yeah, if you rent it. It is also the more you have, the more you pay. And that's life. This one can do something else. I think to wait till these 2 are done. The boatyard will be just construct the boats themselves. It's not that the carpentry is needed for that one. So for the fishing dock you need a boat to fish. I think at this point the city is doing well. You can immediately see that the rent is going up and the land tax going up and the wheel tax of course. And when we have a population of 200 people, then we can place the fern so that we can tax that one also. The fern nowadays is just a cafe that you can go to drink a beer or something like that. Just having some great time with your friends. This one makes boat cloth from wool, so I think this one will be the next one we're gonna place, and it can be here. So let's do it. And if you got a messenger, you also can see here a picture from a man on a horse. And through the winter time you can't fish because the lake is frozen, so it's only 3 months in a year, so not a big deal. I think I will be remove this one. Yes. Then we can build some house here and go easier to this side. Then we make a new field here. Just as big as possible. Like this. Then we're gonna check. I think maybe we can do it here. Also, no. But we have here a fallow field, a wheat field, and on this one will be potatoes. So, potatoes, fallow, and then wheat. And activate it. So, and then we're gonna make here. Smaller one, and here we will make some buckwheat and yeah, we had the wheat, so we're gonna buckwheat it first. 1, 2, 3, yeah, I'm gonna activate it. So we got that all running very nicely, and buckwheat is also a cheap food to make, and also for the people. So the fishing dock is ready. We can order this 3 of them. This one we're gonna make them when winter is over, because they can't complete an order in winter. I think it's stupid, but it's the game. But yeah, we are in January, so winter is almost over. Just a double check to see if this all okay. Looks like yes. So to see an ox is died, then we're gonna make this one an ox and relocate it to there. And then we need a new bull. This will be from this city, so we have to wait when they come. Got a messenger, and he has also some cows, so we're gonna buy a new one. Only the bull, because we have 3 cows, so. They wanna order some potatoes, so we sell 1000 potatoes. We get 80 from them, so. Then we'll check how much potatoes we have left. 2000, so we can put another 1000 into here, and it will stay here until this man is coming to our city, and they will load it up. We can check. There they go. Come, it's the bull. And there is the chart for the potatoes. You can see, just hit it, the normal play speed. They will add the potatoes into the chart and they tend to go back. Yeah, all the small details in this game. The snow is melting. I think dogs will stay alive now. I hope. Then we can put some workers in here. He's building a boat, so we first do two this year, and the next year we will use three workers. We can also, when we hire a counselor, to do manage seasonal hiring, so that we can at a fishing dock that we do just all the months, but not a winter time. So when it's winter, then they go, they will be fired, and when it's spring, they will be getting back. But I tried that a few times and I'm not working that nice as I was expecting, so I won't use it, not at this point. We'll hit use follow field. You have to hit it, then it will use a follow field if available, and if not, we can also make a small field. Just do it like this, a little more. So then it will bring the cows to this place if there's not a fallow field available, because we have the sheep also. So, got 8 sheep now. There's another newborn. There's a female. We got 2 rams. So when we got the slaughterhouse, we will slaughter this one for some meat for the people. We need one here for the milk, because we got milk from the sheep and also from the cows. I think we can place a hate wire here and maybe another one. No. As you can see, how do I work in the field? Then we make some more houses on this side. We hit F1. Do this house a little bit. Then this. Then enter. Then another one. With this function, you can place the buildings more how you like them. I think we built some 4 new houses on this side. Then the other one will get some view on the river. Like this. Then we have to wait until they finish it. And when we build along, we see that our city is growing. We got 13 houses now, and 4 in the making. So that will be 17 houses. So I think when those houses are ready, we will have a population about 55 to 56. So that's already doubled the starting. So yeah. We are doing a good job. And I see that the mill is complaining about that they were full. So let's check flour. Maybe we can sell some. And there is a messenger. So we put 400 in here. We have not that much wheat anymore, but this field is wheat and we get 2200 wheat from that. So they have plenty of flour to buy, so that won't be a problem. We also can turn this button on, so we can see how much is in the market stalls. Can be useful sometimes. In the fields, and I'm not sure what that will do, because I'm not seeing changes. The resident also, workers. Not sure where those buttons are for. But I've always show occupied space on. So when you're building and it's off. Wait. It now stays on, so I'm not sure why. Oh yeah, now you won't see it, but if you hit FM on, you can see it also when you're just moving just around the corner of something, that there's something being built. So it can be useful later on in the game when you have a bigger city and just some small spaces to put something. So these are just the settings that I have here. So I got a new messenger from Balaklia. There's nothing in the export stock, so we can't sell. But I think if we place another worker in here, maybe it's going a little bit faster. I hope. But then this will be the end of this video. Episode 2 of the first season of Ostwith. So I hope you like this video. And if you do, please hit that thumbs up button. And if you are not subscribed to my channel, please do it. You can do it down below. And then I will see you on the next video. And if you have anything you want to know or you want me to do in the next video, please let me know in the comments below. And I always will leave a reaction to your comment. So let me know, guys. Thanks for watching. See you on the next video. Bye.